Imagine a time when the night sky was filled with mystery and wonder, and the boundaries of our solar system were still being drawn. In the early 1800s, astronomers were puzzled by a strange phenomenon that would lead to one of the most remarkable discoveries in the history of science. Today, we'll unravel the crazy way Neptune was discovered, not through a telescope, but through the power of mathematics. Our journey begins with a mystery surrounding the planet Uranus. Discovered by William Herschel in 1781, Uranus expanded our understanding of the solar system. But as astronomers tracked its orbit, they noticed something peculiar. Uranus wasn't moving as predicted. There were slight but undeniable deviations in its path, suggesting the presence of an unseen force. What could it be? This question sparked a quest that would lead to the discovery of Neptune. These anomalies were small but significant enough to catch the attention of the scientific community. Many theories were proposed, ranging from the presence of a nearby star to a hypothetical planet beyond Uranus. However, without concrete evidence, these ideas remained speculative. The search for the mysterious force began, and with it, a new chapter in the story of our solar system. Le Verrier, a meticulous and determined mathematician, believed that the key to solving the puzzle lay in Newtonian mechanics. He hypothesized that the gravitational influence of an unknown planet was affecting Uranus's orbit. With this theory in mind, Le Verrier embarked on a series of complex calculations aiming to predict the location of this hypothetical planet. His work was rigorous and exacting, requiring immense patience and precision. Meanwhile, across the English Channel, a young mathematician named John Couch Adams, only at age 24, was also grappling with the problem. Inspired by the same anomalies, Adams independently began his own calculations. Despite his youth and relative obscurity in the scientific community, Adams was driven by an insatiable curiosity and a determination to uncover the truth. His work paralleled Le Verrier's, and both men would soon find themselves on the brink of a monumental discovery. Le Verrier and Adams faced a daunting task. They needed to use the irregularities in Uranus's orbit to predict the position of an unseen planet. This required not only mathematical prowess, but also a deep understanding of celestial mechanics. The stakes were high and the margin for error was slim. Le Verrier, known for his meticulous approach, dove into his work with relentless determination. He analyzed the perturbations in Uranus's orbit, applying Newton's laws of gravitation to predict the mass, position, and orbit of the unknown planet. Each calculation brought him closer to a potential solution, but the process was fraught with challenges. Errors could easily creep in, and the data had to be checked and rechecked. On the other hand, Adams, working in relative isolation, faced his own set of difficulties. His initial attempts to communicate his findings to the British astronomical establishment met with indifference. Despite these setbacks, Adams persisted, refining his calculations and becoming increasingly confident in his predictions. By 1845, both Le Verrier and Adams had arrived at remarkably similar conclusions. They believed they had pinpointed the location of the mysterious planet that was perturbing Uranus's orbit. However, their predictions were only theoretical. The next step was to confirm their findings through direct observation, a task that would require the collaboration of skilled astronomers and the use of powerful telescopes. The stage was set for a dramatic discovery. Le Verrier sent his calculations to the Berlin Observatory, urging them to search for the predicted planet. On the night of September 23rd, 1846, Johann Gottfried Galle, along with his assistant Heinrich d'Arrest, took up the challenge. They pointed their telescope to the coordinates provided by Le Verrier, filled with anticipation. The tension was palpable as they scanned the night sky. Hours passed, and then, almost miraculously, they spotted a faint blue dot. It was a new planet, exactly where Le Verrier had predicted. This was a monumental moment, a triumph of mathematical prediction and observational astronomy. Neptune had been discovered, not through the lens of a telescope, but through the power of calculation. The discovery of Neptune was met with widespread acclaim, but it also sparked a fierce debate. Both Le Verrier and Adams had independently arrived at the same conclusion. The scientific community was initially divided, with some giving more credit to Le Verrier due to the prompt confirmation of his predictions. Adams, on the other hand, faced challenges in asserting his role in the discovery. His communications with the British astronomical establishment had been overlooked, leading to delays in recognizing his contributions. Despite this, the evidence of his independent calculations was undeniable, and over time, he received the acknowledgement he deserved. The rivalry between Le Verrier and Adams highlighted the competitive nature of scientific discovery. The resolution of the controversy eventually led to both men being honored for their achievements, cementing their places in the annals of astronomical history. Today, Neptune stands as a symbol of human curiosity and the relentless pursuit of understanding. Its discovery story continues to inspire scientists and enthusiasts alike, encouraging us to look beyond the visible and explore the unknown. The story of Neptune's discovery is a fascinating tale of mathematical genius, determination, and the incredible power of human intellect. It reminds us of the many mysteries still waiting to be uncovered in our universe. Who knows what other secrets the cosmos holds, waiting for us to discover? If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more fascinating stories from the world of astronomy. Share this video with your friends and let us know in the comments what other topics you'd like us to cover. Thanks for watching and keep looking up at the stars.